rowing the Atlantic is such a weird thing to do. And I really don't know why I'm doing this. I suppose it's because I like a bit of adventure. And this is perfect for me. I think life can get too dull, too boring, too staid, in the same job, monotonous. And this sort of breaks it all up and makes it life worth living, basically.
I literally woke up one morning and 2 years ago decided I wanted to row across the Atlantic.
There's not many places in the world you can go to and be completely isolated, but out on the water, you know, you're lucky if you see maybe 10 ships in the time that you're away. So for me, I really enjoy that disconnect.
My biggest fear is probably the unknown. I'm quite mentally strong. Physically, I think I will be fine.
So the Atlantic Dash is a 5,000 kilometer journey from Lanzarote. So we'll go south of the Canary Islands, grab the trade winds and head over to Antigua. We've been asked to pack food for at least 70 days. We don't expect it to take quite that long. I'm hoping more like 40 or 50 days.
You're rowing for 2 hours, and then you rest for 2 hours, and then you row for 2 hours, then you rest for 2 hours, and that's 24/7, so you never get more than 90 minutes of sleep at a time.
We need 5,000-6,000 calories a day.
It's mostly dried meals, where you pour hot water on, and the noodles expand and become a lovely, lovely, tasty, nutritious meal.
To be honest with you, I do not want to row the Atlantic. I was sort of tricked into it. All I've heard is Antigua. So I've signed up to it and said I'll do it, giving me word. He then dropped in the little bombshell that we have to row there from Lanzarote.
We started off at Tim's rowing club in London, did our first ever row together. That was about 8 months ago. That's the first time we've actually rowed together, or rowed for full stop.
All right, so I'm the skipper of the Velocity Ocean Rowing Boat. The way we find Antigua is the way we've been taught to do. It's punching the coordinates that the weather guy's gonna give us.
That's the truth.
I think the things that's really gonna piss me off are the smallest things. We're gonna be smothered in suntan oil, we're gonna be in and out of cabins every 2 hours. It's gonna be very hard to keep the place clean.
Darren, he's the skipper of our boat, so he's going to be the one barking out orders. To be honest with you, I'm not very good at taking orders.
I think they'll piss me off both equally, actually. When I first get to Antigua, the first thing that somebody's going to hand me is a beer.
I will actually probably have a shower first, and then I'll probably get a beer and take the beer in the shower and drink the beer in the shower.
You have to learn how to get on with each other, and I think giving people that experience is something that will then translate into other areas of life when they come back. I always say take a notebook with you, because where else do you get 12 hours a day to sit and think?
I'm looking forward to really getting to know myself.